brain. You have an undifferentiated process, and then a split, where you're looking for an object, and then the general scattering for many objects. And it's this scattering making many objects which is the cause of the idea world spattering out. I want to show you another very instructive thing in the human organism. If we take the toes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I won't draw the other leg, it's too difficult. We've got two bones in the lower part of the leg, little kneecap, and then one bone, femur, in the top part. And if we take the hand, we find exactly the same thing. 5, 2, 1. Right, if we take the belly, 1, 2 lungs, and head, put our 5-pointed star in there, put our 5 senses, we begin to see a peculiar relation. We have this wholeness, this undifferentiated will, this prime urge so difficult to get at. Then we have the liking and disliking of it, personalities. Then the 5-fold sensorium of it. And we have the same thing in the upper arm bone, the part nearest the body is the most unified. Then the 2 bones, the ulna and the radius there, which are the bones of choice. You'll find that when people are making up their minds, they frequently go like this, unconsciously, rotating the bones. And then your 5 messages here. And the same with the leg, the one nearest the body, unified, then the analysis. And therefore, there is a very peculiar relation between the unified bone of the femur, the humerus, and the lumbar region here, belly. The split here and the split into the lungs and here are also nervously related, and the head and the fingers and the toes. So we find that the very neurotic type, with fingers modelled and bony, not the soft, slushy, snail fingers, with articulated fingers, are a sign of an active mind, and you'll find their toes are of the same order. And remembering that head is under the dominion of the Ram, which is a nervous energy sign, you can expect to see symptoms on the fingertips there that belong in the forebrain, on the next joint that belong in the midbrain, and on the lower joint before it meets the palm in the hindbrain, and the same with the toes. You see, this human being is simply a very simple trinity, repeating itself over and over again. Whatever it throws out, and remember you started life as an egg, whatever it throws out, budding itself an arm and a bit farther, and then 5 little buds like this, and a chubby hand. You see, all those things are expressed from inside, from the original, potentially 5-fold being. The Panchakarana of the yogis, the 5-fold creativeness of the universe, is evidence. You see, from the point of view of Darwinian evolution, it just doesn't make sense that a human being has got those things, and a beetle can be shown to have the same things in a very rudimentary manner, but we didn't descend from beetles. But the same forces are trying to manifest through them. And the farther away from the body these arms grow and the fingers extend from the palm and lengthen, the more the nervous energy of the absolute is pushing itself into the world, and the greater its danger. Because the more you push into the world, the more you extend your nerve lines of communication, the more susceptible of attack you are from without. So the very thing that gives you the greatest sensitivity is also the thing that endangers you the most.